Reframework in UiPath. It's a big and very important topic. In almost every job interview you will be asked, if you know it, or have worked using it. What is reframework? What are the advantages of reframework? Why and when to use it? And many other questions. As mentioned, it's a big topic, therefore I will explain the topic in different videos. In each video I will explain one part of a reframework. And I will also publish other videos, how to use it using different examples, so that you can understand it better and could use it in a useful way. This video will be as an introduction for reframework, to know what is reframework in general, and how to start learning it. In the next videos I will explain it in detail. So are you ready? Let's go! Reframework is a template provided by UiPath. Reframework stands for Robotic Enterprise Framework. It can be used to handle any type of business processes. But what does business process mean and how to implement it in UiPath? Let's see the definition of a business process. It's a collection of related structured activities, in which a specific sequence produces a service for a particular customer or customers. It may be visualized as a sequence of activities, with relevance rules based on data in the process. Or it may be visualized as a flowchart of activities, with interleaving decision points. It means, we have data which be processed using some activities to get an output. The data plays the main role in a process. Depending on the data, the process can be categorized differently. For example, the data can be an Excel file, which consists of many rows. The rows which should be processed are called data. So the rows are the total amount of data. Each row from this file represents a transaction or transaction item. So a transaction represents the minimum amount of data. Depending on the data, we can categorize the process using three different types. These are linear, iterative, and transactional. What does each one mean and what are the advantages and disadvantages of each one? Let's learn more about it. Let's start with linear processes. The linear process looks like this one. We first read the data and then process it in different steps. The steps here are performed only once, from top to bottom. There is no repetition for the steps, which means if a step is executed, it will not be executed again. The data is such processes are minimum, which means that we only have one transaction. The process is executed for this transaction. If we want to process another transaction, we need to run the process again. The most common example for such processes are processes, which works with emails. Once an email received, the process will be executed for this email. If we need to process another email, we have to run the process again. Linear processes are very simple and easy to implement. But in case of repetitions for some steps in the process using different data, it will be not very suitable. We mostly implement such processes using sequence activity in UiPath, but it could also be implemented using flowchart or state machine. The next category is iterative. As the name suggests, we have here repetition in the process. The process looks like this one. We have also get data and process data, but as you see the process data step appears more than once, which means that we process more data than in the first category. So we read here the entire data at once, which we need to process. Then we process them one by one. But here make sure you understood that the data will be read at once. It means, we read the data and then process them. We don't read only one item then process it and then read the next one and process it. This is very important to understand for this process category. An example for these processes is again the Excel file. Here we first read the entire Excel file. Then in the step, process data, we process all rows one by one in a loop. This means, we repeat the same steps for each data item. This kind of processes has the disadvantage, that if a problem happens while processing of one item, the whole process is interrupted, and the rest of the items remain unprocessed. We mostly implement these processes using flowchart activity, but here also we can implement it using sequence or state machine. But flowchart is most suitable one for such processes. And the third and last category is the transactional process. Here we have again the same steps, get data and process data. We also have here repetition as in the iterative processes. But the difference here is, that we read only one data item and process it, then we read the next one and process it. The principle of repetition here is the same as iterative processes. The difference is, as mentioned, that we read only one transaction item then process it, and then the next one and so on. This method has the advantage, that if we have a problem in one item, the entire process will not be interrupted, and the next items could be processed. An example for transactional processes is a process, which works using a queue. So the process gets a queue item, process it and set it as successful or exception. Then the next queue item will be processed and so on. But we can also use this kind of processes without queue. For example, we have some emails in Outlook. So we read only one email and process it. Then we read the next email and process it. We mostly implement these processes using a state machine. So let's summarize these categories. Linear processes are for simple processes, where the execution is only once performed, and only for one data item. The implementation of these processes is mostly using a sequence. Iterative processes are for repetitive processes, where we have to execute the same steps for different data. The data will be read at once. The implementation of these processes is mostly using a flowchart. Transactional processes are also for repetitive processes, where we execute the same steps for different data, but the data is processed one by one after reading it also one by one. The implementation of these processes is mostly using a state machine. A transaction represents the minimum amount of data. For example, we want to read data from different invoices, which are stored in a folder. After that, we want to enter this data into another system. In this case, each invoice can be seen as a transaction, because we have to execute the same steps for each invoice. I mean, we have to read the data from the invoice and enter it somewhere else. So we repeat these steps for each invoice, therefore each invoice is a transaction. So now you know, what kinds of business processes do we have in general, and what does a transaction mean? Let's go back again to the reframework. Reframework, as mentioned, is used to handle any kind of business processes, which I already explained. But we mostly use it for transactional processes. As also mentioned, we use state machine to implement transactional processes. It means that we use state machine for reframework. Or we can say that reframework is based on a state machine. If you don't know what state machine is and how to use it in UiPath, you can check these two videos about state machine. I explained it in detail. Make sure you understand state machine, so that you also can understand reframework. You can find the links for these videos in the video description. Let me show you how to create a process using reframework. First, navigate to home and then under start you can find the following structure. On the right side you can see different templates, which you can use to create a process. We need the first one, Robotic Enterprise Framework. Just click on it to create a process using this template. The following pop-up window appears, where you need to enter the following information. First, you need to write the process name. Here you can rename the process as you want. The next field is for the location, where you want to save the project. I will save it on desktop, for example. And the last one is to enter some description for the process, for example, what is this process for? Then click on Create and the process will be created. As you see, the process is created. I am now in Project tab. Here you can find all workflows, which are created automatically in the project. We have main and process workflows. But we also have other workflows in this folder. We have 8 workflows, which we can use in the project. We have here also a PDF file, where the reframework project is documented. And under data we can find the configuration file, which we can use to store the different variables and assets for the project. Let's open the main workflow. As you see, we have a state machine, which consists of 4 states. These are initialization, get transaction data, process transaction, and process. And we have different transitions between the states. What does each state contain and how can use these to implement our process? I will explain the states in the next videos. In each video I will explain one state from these 4 states. And at the end I will implement some examples using reframework. At the end of this video I will show you what you have to do so that you can learn reframework in easy way. As mentioned, the project based on state machine, therefore you have to learn what is state machine and how to use it. I already talked about the both state machine videos on my channel. So first you have to watch these two videos. Then you have to learn more about try catch and exception handling, because we use try catch in this template in different states and it's very important for reframework. Therefore please also watch the try catch video on my channel. The last thing you have to do, is watching the config file video. I explained it, what does it contain and how to use it. The config file is also important for reframework, because we use it to store variables, which we use for the process. Once you watch these videos, you are ready to learn reframework. As mentioned in the next video, I will explain the different states and then I will implement different projects using reframework. If you have any questions about reframework or a specific need, please write me a comment. Stay safe and see you in the next video in reframework tutorial.